Good morning, St. Francis. Good morning, people of God. It is Wednesday, the first day of the month of May, 2024. It is Wednesday of the fifth week of Easter. It is the, now, because we moved past April, 32nd day of the Easter season. It was always one day more than the day in April. Now you got to remember as you move into May what day it is. So 32nd day of the Easter season. Today we also celebrate St. Joseph the Worker. It's May 1st. So St. Joseph the Worker is also an optional memorial on this day. Again, honoring all of those who labor. So even before Labor Day, the church begins to honor as we move into the month of May. Again, also dedicated to the Blessed Mother. So a whole lot of things happen during May. It is Community Mass Day on this Wednesday of the fifth week of Easter, and Community Mass is just going on now inside of the church with our kindergartners leading us. So here in the Memorial Garden on a beautiful day here in Carolina, it's going to be again hot though, so in between everything else. Our readings for today, the question of circumcision is coming up. And so the idea is that it doesn't matter if you are a follower of Christ or a follower of the law of Moses, if you are going to be a part of the covenant, you have to be circumcised, right? Well, this is where Paul and Barnabas basically disagree. And again, this is a great awakening, even in Paul's mind, you know, because as a Pharisee and as a student of the Pharisees, as Saul, he would never have thought twice about circumcision and the necessity for it to be identified as a part of the family of God, to be part of the life of God. But Paul and Barnabas disagree with this, and they decide to go to Jerusalem to get some answers from the apostles that are still there in Jerusalem, perhaps notably Peter, who seems to still be in Jerusalem at this time. And so they go to Jerusalem, and they are greeted, you know, with joy and wonder and everything else like that, at all the great things that have happened, again, on the missionary journeys into the Aegean area and into Greece. But again, there are Pharisees among them who have become Christians, who are great adherents to the laws of circumcision, and so who basically disagree that Gentiles should not be, that Gentiles need to be circumcised to be members of the covenant. And so a great council is now going to happen. And this will be the Council of Jerusalem, the very first council of the church that is recorded in history, to decide, again, what is the mark of being a member of the covenant? Is baptism enough, or is circumcision also have to follow that? And so it remains to be seen. But again, the whole question, outward marks, you know, outward designations, all of the kind of surface area, literally kind of things that sometimes we get involved with as believers. What makes a Catholic Catholic? Is it how we dress? Is it the ornamentation around us? Is it the kind of vessels that we use in our liturgies and our rituals? Or is it what is in the heart? Is that what matters? And that's a good question to constantly ask, because sometimes we seem to forget this and we go back more to the externals than we do to what is inside. And again, the more pious and the more holy that we are does not necessarily mean that we are closer in relationship to the life of God, you know, than others who may not practice such piety or holiness in their own lives. In the gospel today, we basically have a repeat of Sunday's gospel. So this is where the gospels for the weekdays are the gospels for the weekdays. On the Sundays, they change every 3 years. And so vine and branches on Sunday, vine and branches repeated today. So the same understanding, again, holds true. While Christ is the center and the focus as the great trunk, as the great vine from which we emanate, from which we come as believers in the world and as human beings, you know, in this world, so too we have to remember that branches lead to other branches. And so what is it that we offer, you know, again, in our own lives, as people who help to nourish and to enrich and to guide and to nurture, you know, those who follow us, those who become a part of our own lives. It all works together. To be vine and branches means that for us, again, we who become in many ways our own vines for others to branch out on, have the same responsibility, again, that Christ has, to be people of hope, to be people of forgiveness, to be people of love, to be people of mercy, of giving, and of people basically who are open to what the world can offer and not necessarily closed off because of prejudices or fears or our own agendas and things like that. To be vine and branches, again, God says, Christ says, you can do nothing without me. In the same way, again, us realizing that means that we also can do nothing without each other. That together, again, we form this wonderful entity that is this community of faith, that is this wonder and glory of God here in our midst. Again, Easter again reaffirms our worth. It reaffirms the fact that we matter. Reaffirms the fact that as branches from the vine, we have the right and we have also the responsibility to continue growth in faith, in love, and in life in this world. A continued blessed Easter, St. Francis and people of God, a happy month of May. May the Lord give you his peace.